Okay. Hi guys.
Hi.
Hey. How are
Welcome.
you?
Good, how are you?
Oh, thank you. Welcome to Vesper Vibes. Vesper Vibes. It's gonna truly be a vibe today, guys,
Yes,
because we are
definitely.
celebrating the islands and their independence. We had Jamaica's independence the other day.
Yeah.
And I think we've got another one coming up. Pastor, what's coming up this month? We've got another Independence Day, isn't it?
It's the whole Caribbean
Oh,
that
wow.
they're
Oh.
celebrating emancipation. They all were emancipated on the same day,
Oh, wow.
but they
Okay.
celebrate it on different days. So I don't want to steal my thunder for later. But yeah, so every Caribbean island is celebrating emancipation, freedom, during the month of August.
Nice one. Oh, so it's perfect. It's absolutely
Awesome.
perfect. So we're going to be sharing songs, Bible texts about around freedom,
Yep.
around Caribbean artists, Caribbean music, and Caribbean positivity. That's what we're going to be doing today. All rooted in God, of course. So it's all going to be gospel songs for you guys today. But before we
Yeah.
get to him, we are going to pray to start off.
All right.
Dear Lord, we thank you so much for bringing us together again, where we can share songs of hope, encouragement, and songs from our cultures, our friends' cultures, our neighbors' cultures, and just enjoy the fact that even though we are all different, there is a purpose and there is a type of worship for us, and we just praise you for that. So may we find a song that just fits with our heart, fits with our mood, and fits with our worship for you. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. All right, Tara, would you like to set us off for today with
I
your first song?
would. So my first song would be I Am Free, a featuring Travis Green, and the other artist is Shayna Wilson.
I'm an overcomer by the blood, by the blood. I overcome. Giving me the victory, so I'm an overcomer.
I'm an overcomer
by the blood.
By the blood.
By the blood.
By the blood. I overcome.
I am fearless.
I am fearless.
God is with me.
God is with me.
He's given me the victory.
He's given me
the victory.
The victory.
I love this part, y'all. Holding me, Father has come, and it is done. I am free. I am free. Come on, try me.
I'm an overcomer by the blood, and by the blood
I overcome. Now I am fearless.
Yes, I
Nice.
am free.
I haven't heard that song before, you know.
You have? I looked it up for the first time, and I was and I just loved it when I first heard it.
Yeah, it's a lovely tune, really relaxed. All right, my song is gonna be right. So obviously there's Caribbean people in this group of praise and worshipers from the US,
Right.
but song called Freedom, No More Shackles. And I
Okay.
remember I heard it at a Sunday church I used to visit with my friends in Croydon, and
Right.
they used to sing it with so much energy. And I guess above this all, emancipation, freedom to be who Christ intended us to be. That's
Right.
the head all, and this is what Emancipation Day, and when the Caribbean islands celebrate their independence, this is what they're celebrating.
Right.
Obviously there's still room to grow and stuff like that, but that is what Christ has set up for us, is to be free.
Right.
I love this verse. It says, Romans 6, verse 7, it says, "It is for freedom that Christ has set us free. Stand firm then, and do not let yourselves be burdened again by a yoke of slavery." And that's the aim. And it's in regards to the physical side of things, but
Right.
also spiritual side of things. So this is what this song is about. It's just no more shackles, no more chains binding us, because we are free in Jesus.
All right. Love that song.
Yeah. Oh, you know it.
Yeah, I heard it before.
No, I think sometimes, I don't know, if in church you see that, you know, them people that are just like really, I don't know, sometimes SDA church can be a bit conservative, isn't it?
Yeah,
like
definitely.
What background it has.
Right.
And there's always one person that will be like shaking a tambourine or praising the Lord a bit louder. And I think this just reminds me, like, when you actually truly feel freedom,
right,
it does to other people look a bit crazy, like, oh, she's doing a bit much. But
right
experience it and deep the freedom that you have, it does, right, make you jump higher, clap, sing louder, shout, everything like that. It makes you want to do that, right. So the embodiment of this song, and I can only imagine the freedom, like the juxtaposition between where they were before to where they ended up,
right,
the joy and I just the hope for tomorrow that may come out of that feeling and that, right, must be big. So when people worship, when people praise, when people get excited, it's not for us to be looking like, oh, they're doing too much. Like, they're literally feeling it from their chest, and right, they know their story and why and how they got to where they are now. So right, that's why they're gonna jump, they're gonna sing, they're gonna shout, they're gonna do it all.
Right, there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with showing God praise and the freedom that you do feel, even spiritually in your life, you know, good or bad, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's good to be like, I can worship no matter what other people are saying or what they're looking at you saying. You can't worry about people that's around you. It's about your personal relationship and how you experience your freedom spiritually.
Yeah, and you have to be like that, because at the end of the day, them people around you that are saying these things or looking at you funny, they're not even the ones that delivered you or got, right, you to that freedom. Like, it's actually only God. So just do what you got to do with God and let him be the only one to judge and view you and embrace your worship. That's all that's necessary.
Definitely.
Yeah. So what's what you got for us next, Tara? What you got for us next?
I was actually looking up, so I was like, I was wanted to make sure, because since we're doing this Caribbean, I want to make sure I know the day that Jamaica got their independence. So I see they got it on August 6, 1962.
Yeah.
And yeah, so I'm like, so they've been following more than 300 years under the British control. So I was like, wow, how does it feel for an island to break away from when they used to be a part of the British, you know what I mean? Like, yeah, how is the experience? You know, a couple of people over there in Jamaica that has now living in Jamaica now, right? That, how is it for them over since they've been the independent?
I think I think they're aware of the progression that's still needed there. Mm-hmm. And obviously, a lot of them haven't experienced the transition from what it was under that power. They've only experienced like the celebrations
right.
of the independence. So,
right.
but yeah, I think on the face of it, there is freedom, there is change, definitely, and that's appreciated.
Oh, wow.
But I think there's also still like a desire for European standards sometimes.
Right.
And, you know, this thing, and I think, obviously, I'm not Caribbean. I'm Indian, but I think the rhetoric is similar.
Right.
Where you know that it's almost, we still crave to come back to the UK or crave to come to European countries because we still think it's the be all, end all of it. So I still right. think there's we need to root up, even regards to language side of things.
Right.
Like, I know a lot of them still consider like the people that were over them, their language as their like the standard. So right. even Queen's English over Patois, let's say, right. where that's an amalgamation of their life and culture, which makes them like that's their language. So
right.
there's growth, but definitely progression and definitely a blessing in the fact that they were able to have their independence. Wow. No one can take that away from them.
Yeah,
it's just onwards and upwards. Up right. to that point, it's not a stagnant thing. Right. We've got independence oh. and we're sorted. Got independence. Okay, let's keep moving and become right. freer and freer.
That's right, the, right.
Yeah. Thank
you so much for educating enough on that. But my next song would my next song would be a Caribbean medley from Donna McClurkin. You weren't gonna play that one, were you? You were?
I mean, I'll tell the viewers no, but you know, I was gonna play it, but it's okay.
I figured we were gonna have some similar songs, but yeah, so I'm gonna just play a little small piece of this.
Giving me
sorry, wrong one.
Well, then we're going to sing us some Jamaican songs. But if we sing them, you got to get out of those seats and you got to dance like you're really from Jamaica. Or your parents were from Jamaica. Parents were from Jamaica. But I want you to be true to who you are. Success.
I've got my mind made up. And I won't turn back. Cause I want to see my Jesus someday. I want to see my Jesus someday.
Come on, everybody sing.
I've got my mind made up.
And I won't turn back.
Because I want to see my Jesus someday.
I've got my mind made up. And I won't turn back.
Because I want to see my Jesus someday.
They say this. Goodbye, world. I stand no longer with you. Goodbye, pleasures of sin. I stand no longer with you. I made up my mind to go that way
for the rest of my life.
That's it. I made up my mind to go that way the rest of. Come on, say it again. Say it.
Goodbye, world.
Yes, yes. We have to
make
up.
I love that song so much.
I do too. We have to make up in our minds. We're gonna go God's way. We're gonna be free
mm-hmm.
from everything that's yeah. binding us, you know. And I could imagine
yeah.
The joy that Jamaica feels having their own independence and able to celebrate that with other people that are like-minded as them.
Mm. And I think what I love about that song is that as conservative as Caribbean want to feel being in England or worshipping in England, this song as much as they would be, only hymns are allowed. Everything else is like, when I was growing up, everything else is not of God, you know, hymns right. and hymns alone.
Right.
No matter where you are or how strong they are in that belief, if you played this medley in church, or if you played this song, them lot would be on their feet praising. Like, this was just the one little song they would allow to be a little upbeat, or have a little drum bounce to it, or have a little right. clap vibe to it. So I just loved it. It actually broke the boundaries inside church for us just to relax a bit yeah. from that. So yeah. I would good song, good song.
Awesome.
Have you got a Bible verse for us, Tara?
I do from Galatians 5 verse 1, and it says, "It is for freedom that Christ has set us free. Stand mm-hmm. firm then, and do not let yourselves be burdened again by a yoke of slavery."
Amen. Amen.
So we don't have to be binded. We got to stand firm in what we believe in.
Mm.
Yeah. And don't waver from that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, lovely verse, lovely verse. And I think this can go nicely into my song. The song is Jonathan Nelson, "I Believe." This is the Island Melody.
Okay.
Me and those two words, you know, Tara, medley and melody, they just be mixing up. But, you know, the Island Medley, I believe, a wicked song, actually. Just so nice, so nice. Right.
But everybody get your feet heavy, let's go, come on.
One of my favorites.
Yes. God is truly a God of miracles.
Yes, he is.
I think it takes it to the bigger picture. It doesn't necessarily have to be like our nation's like slavery under another power. Like in our day-to-day lives.
Right.
I think especially maybe my generation or our generation, we haven't experienced that big transition from slavery to freedom. But we have our own personal freedom. So sometimes we can feel a bit disattached from this idea because we're like, okay, we've really been enslaved, or we've never really had that struggle.
Right.
But think of things that you've been a slave to, like food, if it's been.
Right, definitely.
Yeah, if it's been even a person in your life.
Right.
If it's people's opinions, like you can literally be a slave to anything.
Definitely.
That just rules your life, and I think when we start thinking like that, then we'll recognize the need for saving out of those situations.
Right.
And then once we recognize the need for saving out of those situations, we'll recognize our need for God, and not just think, okay, this was a need for my forefathers or
my aunt.
Like is actually a need for us in this day. And so it's just reminding us that song, that God is a God of miracles. So when we acknowledge what we need freedom from, that right. He can actually deliver us from those things as hard as we to do definitely. In that moment.
Definitely. Yeah. Because it's amazing how our minds can really be like in some like a prison, like, because mm-hmm. you're so accustomed to doing things a certain way and letting people control who you are, you know, and what you're doing. You don't even realize that the mind can become enslaved with your thoughts, you know. So we have to be careful and allow God to give us that freedom, even in our minds, that you don't have to be held captive to how people are treating you or and just different things of that nature, which goes to the next song that I'm gonna do. I can't even say her name right, but I think her name is Sinead. Anyway, look it up if it's on Spotify. But it's called I Know Who I Am.
Okay.
A chosen generation.
Amen, amen, amen. I love that, and I love that. She is not Caribbean, you know, maybe in heart, but you're not Caribbean. You've chosen that song. Was it for the vibe of the song, or was it because of the message of the song? What was your
honestly the message in the song? Knowing who you are. You know, and also I like the beat, but basically a lot of people don't know who they are. You know, they having a hard time figuring out who they are, what they're supposed to be doing in their lives. And you know, God has chosen his people, and God will give us directions to show us who we are, what we should be doing in our spiritual growth with him. So, you know, that's the main reason why I chose it.
Love it, love it, love it. And, you know, just a gentle reminder for the peoples, you know, we all rooted from one place. So we come, we back each other, we unite, we share messages just because we're celebrating, you know, the emancipation of the Caribbean islands, you know, the Africans, we got your back. Don't worry about it. We're still promoting it. We got you guys. We've got to support one another and encourage and uplift one another, I think is key. So, you know. We all one peoples, man. It's all good. The next song I've got down is by the Toronto Mass Choir. And I actually just found it whilst I was looking for like a variety of songs to choose. I love a good choir song.
Oh, yes.
And it's just a medley, but I knew some of the songs from the medley, but I didn't know all of them. So right. It's a really cool song, but the Toronto Mass Choir is a beautiful choir. So even after this song, guys, just look at their other songs that they create as well. And it's just beautiful, very eclectic. They have different vibes for each of their songs. But this is their From the Live Experience album. So
okay.
I'm gonna stop it there.
Oh.
But as I was listening to it, I didn't realize the first few times listening to it, it goes woo woo in the background.
Yeah. Oh my goodness. I thought I heard that. I wasn't sure they were just like whoop, you know, whatever it was going on in the song. But yeah.
That was the Caribbean Praise Medley by Toronto Mass Choir. Like, it gets better from there. Lovely
self
songs.
Oh my goodness, I had a hard time looking for some music, you know. I was like, okay, what am I looking for? So, you know, I'm like, maybe all of it won't be the Caribbean style, but I'm hoping that it had that little groove to it, you know, to the music. But I definitely love that one that you just did.
Yeah,
like that one, I gotta look them up. I think my next one I'm gonna do is God Is Good by the Grace Thrillers. Let me turn my volume up first. Ooh. There it goes.
God is good. God is good. God is good to me. How could I let him down? How could I let him down? How could I let
to me.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Listen, I was just looking up that. So today would be today that Jamaica celebrates the 59th year of their independence. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So I just wanted to put that out there. That's all, that it was the 59th year, you know, that you guys celebrating, the, you know, the independence.
All right. Congrats.
So God is good. So that's why I chose that one. God is good.
I don't know if Pastor popped up on the screen for that song to do a little bit of a
for us. I know he was grooving a little bit.
He was. Very borderline holy. Yeah, watch. But in regard, actually, on top of that, Psalms 30 verse 11 says, "You turn my wailing into dancing. You remove my sackcloth and clothe me with joy." And I think sometimes we're fearful of, you know, moving to Jesus.
Right.
But he's saying, like, he, through his works in our lives, through his miracles, through his power, right, he's saying, that place of wailing, you're not supposed to be in and you're not supposed to stay in.
Right.
And he's, okay, there's a counter thing that you can do that is on the opposite end of wailing. And he's saying here that it is dancing. Right. So don't everybody tell you that dancing, obviously, you know, dancing for Jesus, but there's standards to it. But don't let anybody tell you that dancing is not a form of worship or right, celebration of who God is.
Right.
I think European standards and Catholicism and in its strictness of worship has really filtered into life.
Right.
And I just feel like we just need to reclaim, like, our natural way of being. Like, right, it's our go-to in every other situation. If we're happy, that doesn't involve God. That's in different places. If we're happy, if we're excited.
Right.
Dancing. But it's like when we come into church, it's like, oh no, we can't.
Right. No. You freeze up. Like, I can't, I'm not going to do anything because people are going to be like, what is wrong with this person? Because yeah, they want to give glory to God. And David danced, and that was his way of expressing his love for Jesus. And I think we can do that same thing. That doesn't mean we have to go worldly with it. It's about staying in, you know, in the regional of showing Jesus that you love him. You know what I mean? Despite what people think.
I mean, even if you guys are nervous, you can start off with Tara and I's lovely shoulder moves that you see throughout our Vesper Vibe sessions, you know, giving a statement during the song.
Yeah.
You've got to pay us a bit of money to use these dance moves, give us the credit. But right, yeah, you've got them. We're giving them in it, Tara. They can use them. Yeah, we're good, guys.
Definitely.
Oh, but yeah, appreciate it. All right, so the next song's gonna be Avion Blackman, and it's called Yeshua, and it's a really beautiful song, and it's actually been recommended by Pastor Ray Patrick. The boss man of reggae and you know, Jamaican and Caribbean music. But yeah, Avion Blackman, Yeshua. Jesus Christ, beautiful, beautiful song.
Yes, I like that one. Send that to me, please.
I'll see what I can do for you. Well, for those who didn't catch it, it was Avian Black Man, Yes You Are.
Yes.
Avian Black Man. Beautiful song and beautiful, like, vibes to it.
Definitely.
Very nice. Yes. We had on the air drums halfway through the song. But yeah, praise God.
I was just getting into it and then you faded it right on out.
I'm sorry, man. I mean, you know, we've got more to the show. Do you know what I mean?
We do.
We can play it again at the end.
Yeah, definitely. But I really want to go to Jamaica one day. I've never been.
Yeah, same.
I want to go and just, I know a couple of people that's there, but I would love to have that experience for myself. Even though I lived in Bermuda, of course, it's different than Jamaica, but I would definitely love to see how it is, the beaches, you know, just all around how the people are there.
Yeah. Do you know what? We have actually now like an influx of Jamaicans and Caribbeans in general, but actually namely Jamaicans that are coming in back to Ghana to kind of get to know their roots and certain places in Ghana as well. Oh, wow. So I'm going to do a little exchange and I want to go to Jamaica. It's just so many beautiful people I know from Jamaica.
Oh,
and
yes.
Yeah, Barbados I've been to, and that was just overwhelmingly beautiful. So yeah, I want to go back to Jamaica, back to Barbados, and then visit Jamaica as well. Caribbean islands just look fantastic. I know there's more to it than what the tourists see, quote unquote, you know.
Right.
But a little bit of time everywhere. On the whole, it's just so beautiful it looks.
Yeah.
Yeah. Caribbean producers, great people, man. Honestly.
Yeah, I would say so. The Jamaicans I have met has been really nice people. So I can't say, you know, nothing bad about it, you know, so.
Master is getting excited, but you know, there's a few anomalies to the great people that come out of the Caribbean. He's one of the anomalies. It's okay, man. It's okay. No, the gospel channel. No, put the finger down, sir. All right. We're good. Tara, have you got another song for us before we hand over to Pastor Ray?
Okay. I hope this is appropriate, but it's Rock of Ages. So I figured I'm going to just play it. On the side of Rock of Jesus and their independence and knowing that what they're doing, the longer they keep God first, and they won't fail.
Amen. I love that song. That's a proper staple song, you know, Rock of Ages.
Yeah.
It was a nice one. All right, we're going to hand over to Pastor Ray now for him to share a word for us to round things up. Ray's Roundup is what we've entitled his little chatty bits now. So I'm going to ask if you can pin him to the screen.
Okay.
So I pinned myself. So.
Oh, all right.
myself. Good day, Tara, Josephine. Been jamming to your Vesper vibes. I won't tell you whose music I appreciate the most.
Not a competition. It's not a competition.
Okay, no problem. Definitely the good vibes. And I just had an idea for our whole program for the radio called Reggae Vibes or Gospel Reggae Vibes, let me say. And a 2-hour show, I'm putting it out there. Nothing but music from the Caribbean, and every now and then one from Africa. but no, man, it was good. I never heard Rock of Ages quite like that.
Yeah.
You guys are talking about Jamaica. I know it's their independence, but need to let the world know that there's many more islands in the Caribbean as well. Amen. To several of them. And my favorite, of course, is the one where I'm from called Grenada. That's where my family's from before they were transported from Africa. And I'm happy to be from the little island of spice and everything nice. There is an emancipation, they tell me, that happened in the month of August in the year 1834. And if you know anything about those dates, you will know, hallelujah, you will know that was before America was emancipated. So the Caribbeans were emancipated before America was emancipated. Wow, that is big news. That is big news. We always thought that America held the key, Tara, to freedom. But the first statistic or the first point I want to give you as we look at our physical emancipation here on Earth, of course, is emancipation for the Caribbean happened before America was set free. The second stat I want to give you, or information I want to give you, is that slaves were emancipated but were not set free. If you look in the history books, it would tell you that in 1934, emancipation took place in the month of August 1. However, in 1838, they still had slaves, and slaves were still being bought and sold. Therefore, it lets us know that emancipation was only a term and not reality. It was only a term and not reality. I thought that was very interesting when I came over that, because in some ways, as we look at our own lives here on the planet Earth, we could say that the same thing is going on, and that is we have freedom in name. And the Caribbean islands have their independence now. But the reality is the colonialistic fathers that held us in oppression for over 400 years, they still rule us, run us, and we cannot do anything on those islands without their permission. Every island except Trinidad has a governor general that is sent here by the Queen, and that lives there and runs the Queen's affairs on the islands. And hence the reason we have the Commonwealth, which the Queen and Prince Charles is now the head of. Trinidad is a republic, so they decided not to honor the Queen as their head of state. They wanted to be totally free. As of next year, Barbados will be a republic, and Barbados will separate themselves from the British colonialistic powers. And I see the other islands going the same way. But Trinidad is the island that has stood out alone and have gone against that level of freedom, of slavery that was given. Let me hasten on. There were two groups that were free before emancipation. One was former American fighters that were black, and they were set free on the Caribbean. And the other one was Muslim blacks that were fighting for the British Army, and they were set free before the indigenous Caribbean blacks. And of course, by where indigenous, I mean those that came from Africa, because we're really indigenous to Africa. A couple other things you may want to know. The third group that fought their way out to freedom before emancipation is the individuals we call the Mandingo. And if you know anything about your slavery roots, you will know that the Mandingos, Tara, particularly from the southern part of America, where you come from, landed themselves in the Caribbean, and there was great warfare. And of course, they set themselves free. And they said that they owned land, houses, crops, and everything. They were very independent before emancipation. There are some information about the emancipation of the Caribbeans. If I were to tie a spiritual twist to it, I would say this, hallelujah, that when you accept Christ as your savior, and the Bible says, hallelujah, if you love, then you are set free indeed, hallelujah. When Christ's love is in you, you are free. Even if the rest of the world is in shackles, brethren, there is a smile on your face. There is an excitement in your step. And that's why most songs that come from the Caribbean are happy songs. You got to move something. Come on now. All the songs you guys have been playing, you got to move something. And that's because despite what we've gone through, brethren, Christ was always central. And the slaves will tell you, and the slaves that landed in the Caribbean, they will tell you, hallelujah, they will tell you that the common denominator to their happiness was their love for Jesus Christ. They never lost him in Africa. They never lost him in the boats coming across to the Americas. They never lost him in the Caribbean. They never lost him on the boats that came from the Caribbean over to Liverpool and Bristol, where we now sit. And the good news is, you can lose everything, but if you don't lose God, you will be one day eternally free. My emancipation day from this planet is on the way. The question I have for you is, are you going to stay in bondage, or are you going to accept the freedom that Jesus brings? God bless you.
Amen, amen,
amen. Amen, amen.
Powerful, powerful. Thank you.
Thank you, Pastor.
Good, good. You got a little Caribbean song for me to leave on?
Amen. Oh, for you. We've got Waymaker, Christafari. And even me, Tara, her name, I call her Sinai?
Sinai?
I don't know. It's all right.
Yeah, yeah.
All right. Thank you so much, Pastor, for that. And this is the song we're gonna leave with you, and it goes hand in hand with what you've just spoken.
Right.
Christ is the only ideal of freedom, and there's even a verse I was gonna read before, 2 Corinthians 3:17, and it says, "Now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom." And I think that just shows it supersedes physical bondage. It supersedes circumstances around us, as long as in your mind and your spirit is tied to Christ,
right?
Physically chained up, but mentally you're free, and that's the best kind of freedom to have in Christ until he comes and we're actually set free proper. But yeah, thank you so much for that. Thank you guys for joining us. We've appreciated you. Don't forget to follow us
and subscribe.
Oh yeah, exactly. We've got Instagram, we've got Facebook, we've got Twitter,
mm-hmm.
and we've got YouTube, and we've got a website. So we're really spoiling you guys, isn't it, Tara?
Definitely.
Well cheated.
And let me just say, you're talking about God interest, right? I never heard you say the name of what they need to be following.
I'm sorry, you need to be following God interest.
Thank you, YouTube.
On Facebook, on Instagram, on Twitter, God Interest. Don't forget that name.
Amen.
Gosh, Tara, that was very eloquent of you. So until next time, guys, for Vesper Vibes, this is me, Josephine. See you.
Tara Goddard.
peace in the Middle East. I'm sorry, the Caribbean.
Exactly.
And happy Independence Day to all the Jamaican people.
Yep, and Emancipation Day to all the Caribbean as well. We appreciate you guys and your impact you've had across the world with your spirit, with your talent, with your music, everything. We appreciate you and intellect. Yes. Thank you so much. But until next time, we'll leave you with Waymaker, Christafari.
Yep.
Lord, we thank you for bringing everyone together. Please be with us as we go our separate ways. May we embrace our freedom in you most of all, Lord, and progress to where you want us to be and who you want us to be. In your name we pray. Amen.
Yeah, turn my life.